Father has a plan, though it's hard to see it now. You feel you're walking all alone, but He is there, no doubt. When the storm around you rages and you're tossed to and fro, when you're faced with life's decisions, not sure
all kneel for prayer. Heavenly Father, creator of the heavens and the earth, we come before your throne in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and King. With the help of the Holy Spirit, we thank you, Lord, for this another gift of life. We thank you for all of the blessings that you have given us and that we are able to gather you this Sabbath morning. We thank you for your truth and that we are enlightened and directed to it, and for the gift of family and friends. And we are sorry, Lord, for all of our sins and iniquities, and please forgive us for our sins in thoughts, words, and in deeds. And please give us the help of the fruits of the Holy Spirit, that we may understand everything that will be said this morning, and that we may apply the new learnings in our life, and that we may keep the Sabbath day holy until the sun sets. And please protect us from evil spirits and evil temptations that are wanting to overcome us this Sabbath day. And all this we ask and pray with the holy precious name of Jesus Christ, through the help of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. It means that we need to always trust in the Lord with all our hearts, and we should not trust ourselves.
1 Timothy 6:6. Godliness is great gain.
I thank God for the protection for the whole month of November.
Psalms 95:3. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. I'm thankful for this wonderful Sabbath and I'm thankful for this wonderful Sabbath day.
Matthew 24:13. That he and shall endure and to the end the saved shall be saved. Happy Sabbath.
My verse found in Psalms 116:13. I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I'm thankful for God that he gave me food and guidance and protection.
My verse is Psalms 119:105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. It means that God is our lamp unto our feet and he'll lighten our path. And no one can harm us or destroy us. I'm thankful that God gave me food and blessings, and I'm thankful that God made the Sabbath day holy.
Okay, so before I begin my testimonies and praises, I'm going to thank God. I'm going to begin with my thanksgiving. And since God has taught us to be thankful in everything, I'm thankful to God for the blessings, especially for the good health, because that's the most important thing. Because when a person got sick, no, makita natong the work will get delayed. No, I remember Miadi when she got sick. No, that's when I realized that it's very important that kaning really have to learn to know the things kaning kanabitang wapata nakabalo that the person knows. We have to learn to know the different kind of work, because if that particular person is not there, no, who will do the work? No, that's why when Rika and Bibi left, no, I had this kind of feeling that, oh, what if Junbi will left too? No. That's why I told them that you have to teach me about all this kind of thing. You have to teach me how to connect the wires. What's the function of this wire? Because, diba, kaning if this person or another din siya, and then he said, no, I'm not gonna go home. But what if you get sick? No, what if Miadi is not there or whatever? Who knows the operating system? So kinsa may mo operate, diba? Or not just me, also you guys. No, all of us needs to know that kind of thing, especially for the work of God. Right? And that's why, though we can't just get it in one click, but eventually we will learn it. Right? That's why I encourage you guys that don't just sit in aisle and do nothing. You have to go somewhere else or read your Bible in your free time, because that will help you grow as well. And that will be a very big help for the work of God. And then you have to go to the field and do something. Don't just sit around. That because I believe that everyone has a hidden talents that God has given to everyone, but wala pa lang na develop. No, it's not being developed because you're not exploring it. You didn't know that you have that kind of talent. No, you didn't know that, oh, you're so good at sleeping. No, you didn't know nga kaning kabalo man day ka ani nga mga butang, because you're not exploring. That's why you didn't know. That's why it's very important that if you have an opportunity to learn, grab it. And in terms of, speaking of exploring, I remember a friend who told me about this before, that go to the world and have fun. You know, you're still young. Explore the world. And I was like, before, no, you were still young. And oh, I went to the world, I explore, I have fun, I have a lot of friends. And then yeah, I went to the school. It's very grabe juga itong kuan nga kaning joining different contests. Though it's not like a great thing compared to you guys, but to me that's so very big already, because I already know the truth. But at the end of it, you know, I was very guilty. The guilt was over me because I did not please God with my talents that he has given to me, and the world just benefits me a lot. And that's why I decided to not to go to the school anymore. I stand in front of my parents, though it's disappointed them, but I stand that I will not go anymore. And I just see the impact of the world in my life when I went right there, and it's not good. And that's why I encourage everyone to just explore. And I remember what my friend just told me, that, or whatever what he meant to say when he said that. And it's not actually about exploring the world in a things, and we still have a long time to explore, and we're not old enough to do things. And you know, when Satan sees that you're trying, when Satan sees that what you're fighting for and what you're trying to do, of course he will give you a lot of different situations that you will see that it's very impossible. But that's why God is keep on telling us to kanabitang have faith always, because this is just what we see, but God see what's beyond. And that's what is the most important thing that we have to look forward to, not just because that's the opposite of our faith, diba? Because faith is the thing that we can't see. Yes, that's right. And yeah, we should not depend on what we see. We need to have faith. Because, you know, it's good to, when you lay down in your bed and you get to say that, oh, I learned something new today. Okay? Have you experienced that? Kanang makaanak ka ba nga? Oh, not just in work, in different kind or any aspect of life, like spiritually. Oh, I learned a lot of new things today. Or I read these verses, it's very nice. Or I became patient today. I was very patient today. Just like that kind of thing. And it's very nice that we'll increasing, right? Because this is what God wants us to do, that we'll increase. It's good to step forward and not backwards, right? Yes, and that's very important, that every day we should grow. Well, you know, just a little kid, that when you're learning, of course, it's a part of life when you're falling. No, that's a part of life already. So don't get discouraged. Just stand up and walk again. And because it's very important that knowledge is the most important thing to get in. You just like, for example, no, sa ako nga, in my situation, I didn't know about, just like for example, I didn't know about the mixture of the soil of this particular plant or this aglonema that wants this medium soil mixture. I didn't know about that, or the huya needs just this cocoa husk alone. I didn't know about that, but what I'm trying to say is that kanabitong, what I'm trying to say is that small knowledge that you have, you can spread that to the people around you. There's a lot of people don't know about that yet. There's a lot of people who don't know about that, and you can share it to them. You can even share it to your friends. Right? You can share it to your kids in the future. Right? And then, yeah, you freely receive that knowledge, and you can also freely give what you learn. And my last verse is found in 1 Peter 4:10. As every man hath received the gift, even so minister the same one to another, as good stewards of the manifold grace of God.
So there's not much to say, because I have the same routine every day, but that doesn't mean that I'm not facing battles. No. First, I would like to thank God as always for the provision, protection, and right now I have now good health, because I had fever last Tuesday, but. But the good thing is it only appeared on just one day, no? And then I got healed the next day. And also, I would like to thank God for the strength, for the borrowed strength. We all face different battles, but through Christ's powerful name, we overcome obstacles. And that really amazes me. So we just need to ask God, no, for strength. Because nang naitay dagang mga lahi-lahi na pagsulay ba nya, we don't know, kanang sometimes kanang on our own we don't know how to work it out. Yeah, we just know kanang God is always there. No, we just need to call him, to call out for him and ask for help, especially kanang ask for the strength that we need. And in Psalms, I'd like to share this verse. Psalms 29 verse 11. The Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. So if you ask God for strength, he will give it. He will not fail you this kani siya na matter, but dili kanya i-fail, no? Kay I have an answered prayer, but instead kanang he gave me strength, no, nga kanang dili ra ko ma-dismay ba, nga kanang padayon lang gyapon ko, I will remain anang hopeful and faithful to him. So I hope kanang everybody sad no inana pod nga dili ta angay mawagtangan og kanang paglaom ba, because kanang God is able to do everything or to give everything for us. And that's all, thank you.
Happy Sabbath to everyone. I'm going to read the testimony or thanksgiving from our brother, Brother Gerson from Ghana, West Africa. So, hello church. I just want to thank the Lord for his unending love, mercy, protection, and his provision. Above all, I want to thank him for life and for his leads as we pass through the storms. I come to realize that he allows us experience these hard times in order to make us more conform to the image of the Lord and Savior. Troubles makes us to see the real you, or as in light we're supposed to see it. It helps to be humble enough to get closer to him. It also helps see the defects in our characters and helps us shape it. Our reactions in these times of trouble steals our place in Christ. I thank the Lord for this. It's my experience. I would have wished to sing a hymn, but sister, I'm having Qatar, and I lose my voice. God bless the church. Amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to all. Okay, I'm going to read the testimony of or the comment of Brother John G. Curtis. Okay. It says, I had just recently learned that Saturday is the Sabbath day, and that Sunday worship is the worship of the Sun God, and fortunately, the church never taught me that. I walked away from the church 30 years ago, and I'm 63 years old now. I'm from America, and there is no like-minded churches anywhere near me. I don't even believe they exist in America. They're all denominational, and each teaches and have their own beliefs. They are not of one mind, but one mind, body, and spirit. It would be great to have fellowship with like-minded church. My home is my church and my King. And my King James Bible teaches me through God's Holy Spirit that I've been spreading the truth of God's word and the truth of salvation in Jesus Christ's name only on Facebook, which became my platform to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. I guess you can say that I have fellowship with SDC Studio today. I was watching your video and I noticed you have a small congregation because you stand for the truth of God's word and the truth of salvation and Jesus Christ's name only, and that you only read and study out of the King James Bible, and that you're not affiliated with any denominational church or even tax exemption church. So that makes you the true church of Jesus Christ. If I had the means, I would move out of America and move where you're from. And I believe you're from the Philippines, not only because of the people, but because of some of the wildlife. I noticed the palm trees, it looks tropical. Perhaps one day, God willing, I can come visit your church to meet my true brothers and sisters in the Lord. Well, God bless SDC Studio and your church members. Amen.
Okay, good morning everyone and happy Sabbath. Yeah. And first, I would like to thank God for the protection and good health for the whole month of November. And all the blessing that he poured out and Let all the praises be given to Him as He is the provider and the source of everything we need. And also, I would like to thank Him also for my new work which is in the garden. Yeah. And according to Psalms chapter 30 verse 12, to the end, and my glory may sing praise to Thee and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks unto Thee forever. And that's all. And good morning.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. My verse in Psalms 50:15. And call upon me in the day of trouble, I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify me. In the times of trouble, He is the one we can trust on, for He is faithful in all His ways, for His plan is greater than ours. Therefore, we should always put our faith in God, because He promised that we will be with us even unto the end of the world if we will obey His commandments. My testimony is I thank the Lord for the months of November, for guiding me and protecting me, especially in work, for giving me a good health and healing.
Good morning, everyone, and happy Sabbath. I praise God, and I thank Him for the blessings and that we receive from Him, and also the protection and the strength, and for the good health, especially the Holy Spirit that is always guiding us, and His loving kindness. My verse can found in Philippians 4:19, but my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. It means all that Christ have received from God, we too may ask, have, then ask and receive, and God will give us if we obey His word and His commandments. Jeremiah 17:7, blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. And that's all.
Happy Sabbath. Okay. Every day is a blessing. God said His word. You will receive. Surely His word is true. Not once or twice have I asked for His help, and He came through for me. I thank God for always being with me, for keeping my life always, for giving us Lixi our puppy, who give us so much joy, and Canper Shelly is our problems. Psalms 86:12, I will praise Thee, O Lord my God, with all my heart, and I will glorify Thy name for evermore. Juditos Kwan. I thank God for the uncountable blessings which He have showered upon me. I thank Him for the health, happiness, and wealth, for the protection, the safety everywhere I go. Psalms 118:28. Thou art my God, and I will praise Thee. Thou art my God, I will exalt Thee. Thank you.
Good morning, and happy Sabbath once again. Yes, we're so thankful that we have the testimony and praises to have the chance to glorify God. And yeah, for this testimony, I just like to be thankful of the blessings I received for the people around me, for having God, who is always be with us, and who always help us in times of need. And I'd I would like to emphasize also my professional being a teacher. I just want to I just realized that being a teacher is not really easy. In the world, a lot of people, I don't think a lot of people like to be a teacher because there are a lot of preparations. But yeah, for me, I was able to love my profession that time that I graduated from college. So before that, I didn't really think that I would become a teacher. But there's always a reason why, and God direct me to this path. So I'm very thankful because being like, if you are able to impart your knowledge to the children, to the people, even if you have, for example, have a lot of personal struggles, difficulties, but you're still able to give light to others, make others still happy, like what I do know in my like online and also to the children. So I just realized na it's hard today to be a teacher, but in spite that I received so much blessings from God. Spiritually, He strengthened me, and for giving me so much wisdom. So even if I lack some things, like I'm not that talented in all things, but at least what has God given me, I am able to love it, nurture it. So in that way, I can say that I have a purpose in life, no? So even if we lack some things, even if we are not good in all in some things, but you have to think that we have different purposes. We have different roles here in on earth. So because here in 1 Corinthians 12:27-31, it says, "Now ye are the body of Christ and members in particular, and God hath set some in the church, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healings, helps, governments, adversities of tongues. Are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, are all workers of miracles? Have all the gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But covet earnestly the best gifts, and yet show I unto you a more excellent way." So even if we are not in that category, no? Miracles, prophets, and so on, but it says there helps. So in any way you can help, then you are a big, big help to the church. And that's all. Thank you. Thank you.
once again, and happy Sabbath. Okay, so cleanliness is not next to godliness, but it's part of living a godly life because God hates anything unclean. And how we clean our space reflects who we are. Well, our life lately has been very busy, literally, very busy. There is no excuse for us to not be able to take care of our home. God has given us 6 days to do our task, and it's up to us on how we manage our time. However, if we want to make excuses, then we really cannot accomplish anything. Coming here Thursday evening or an early Friday morning has become rare for us these times. And while we can only plan on what we want to do for the day, only God can direct our steps so we may be able to accomplish what we plan to accomplish. And so for that, I'm thankful for God for allowing us to be here early yesterday. And for that, and for what seems like a never-ending home overhaul with only 9 hours max to beat before sunset, we were able to finish cleaning up the entire house, emptied out our fridge, threw out the garbage, prepared food for the Sabbath, among others, just right on time. A purposeful intention, a willing heart, and hard-working hands can truly make a difference. A special shout-out, though, to my daughter, Jamie, for willingly and done her areas of assignment and who cooked her Sabbath food, cooked her portion for the Sabbath without complaint. And to Mia also, and to my husband, Manji, who were our additional help as well. And at the end of it all, no matter how much aching muscles we had, it's very rewarding for us because truly, a clean home equates with a peace of mind. And oh, thanks to my husband also for the spa-like massage last night. No pun intended. Further, I thank God for reminding me that we cannot please everybody. And this allowed me to take a good look of myself and make good realizations out of it. Such as still thanking for the following people who are ungrateful and who put me in a bad light because they're not really worth my while. Those who can't keep their mouths from other people's issues because they're just showing their true colors. Those who just cared enough for themselves because at the end of the day, they're just also left with nothing but themselves. Additionally, I also want to thank God for allowing a series of tempting opportunities to come my way. Because each time, I get to deny myself from those opportunities and to choose God first, for not all opportunity comes from God. And the more that we get tested, the more that we should over and over again say no to what can separate us from the love of God. Lastly, thank God for the healing when everyone in the family was sick, one after the other, not all together, because we get to take turns in taking care of each other, including to our new source of joy, just like Ate Sally and Judito, they have Lexi, we also have our baby Asu. So, to end my testimony, I'd like to share a well-known passage which reminds us that God intended a proper time for everything, including how we do our daily activities. Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. Be blessed. Thank you.
The Lord Jesus. Today I would like to thank God for the blessings that we received from you, church. We thank God for the help from the church. May God bless you all. May God fulfill the desires of your hearts. I also thank God for the life of here in the village. I really praise the Lord for the strength which he has given to me. I can live here in the village. I really praise the Lord. In the beginning, I didn't know if I could manage this life, but the Lord is good. I can manage this village life. Also, apart from managing this life, I have been facing some challenges from the family members. Some family members are not happy with my decisions that I have taken. some of them don't even understand about my future plans, but I really continue to stay here and to worship the Lord and to keep the Sabbath. But I hope God will continue to protect us. Also, I thank God for my brother. My brother came back at home and he stayed for some 3 months ago. Before, he had been away from home for 7 years. But now he has gone away and we don't know where he is again. So I really ask you, church, to keep him in your prayers so that the Lord may help him to come back again at home. Also, I am really strengthened by the word of God. When I read the story of Esther and the story of the Israelites when they were delivered from the Egypt country when they were slaves, those stories are really strengthening me. So I continue to read the word of God, which is really strengthening me and it is giving me the strength to continue to pray and to continue to keep the hope in God, because if God helped them, he can also help us in all the challenges which we pass. So always we should keep our hope in God, God of Jacob, God of Israel. He is the same God who is really protecting us until today. Happy Sabbath to you, church. That's all about my testimony and thanksgiving today.
I would like to begin my praises with a chapter in the book of Psalms 149. And I would like to also greet our church family all over the world. You may not see them. Dito kakita nila, no? But they send emails to us and saying that they're listening and watching our worship services and the YouTube videos that we upload in our channel. Psalms 149 has only 9 verses. The book of Psalms is full of praises. Have you noticed that? So can you imagine the life of David? He was always praising, right? And he also recalled the experiences of Israelites in the past. You can find that in the book of Genesis. You have Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. Those books focused on the experiences of God's people. And then you have Judges, Kings, and so on, until you have the last book, the book of Revelation, which reveals to us what will happen in these last days. And maybe some people would ask why the COVID, blah blah, and all this jab and all these lockdowns and all this chaos all over the world, because this is worldwide. No, it's not just in one particular country, like they always blame China. Have you heard? They blame China, right? They were so upset at China. But then when you read the Bible, there's a nation that you should be pointing the blame to, right? It's in the book of Revelation chapter 17. So if you study the Bible, you will not wonder why these things are happening, why there's lockdowns or travel restrictions and this and that, because they are testing the waters. Because time will come when they will enforce this so-called fake Sabbath worship, which is Sunday. Then they will understand how to get to the people. Oh, number one is scare tactics. They're going to scare them. Oh, there's a virus. You better wear this and that. You better stay at home. Don't go to the streets or to the neighbors. Don't go to crowded areas. So these are all planned because the great event is yet to come, and that's we have been preparing for, and it's called the law to worship on Sunday. But if we read the Bible, the Sabbath is not the first day of the week, but the seventh day of the week. Before I read the book of Psalms, I would like to share something that I have thought, and I've shared this to Craig too. If you notice, you see Genesis, this is in the Old Testament, or the first, I would say, the first set of books, and then you have the second, right? The first set of books contain the first five. You have Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. The book of Genesis tells us the story of creation, right? So the question is, who wrote the book of Genesis? Do you know? Who wrote the book of Genesis? Moses. Adam? Adam did not write. Did he write something? No, wala, no? So Moses. So my question is, how did Moses know the creation? Yes, he received a vision. I was moved by the Holy Spirit to understand and write. It's like he was not there in the Garden of Eden. He received a vision showing what happened in the Garden of Eden, and with his human understanding, through the help of the Holy Spirit, he wrote the best way possible for us to understand. And so you have Genesis, and then if you backtrack the days that before he was born, all those were from visions. Isn't it amazing? It's amazing, right? Because if God did not send a vision to Moses, then how would we know about creation? How would we know that on the seventh day, God ended his work? How did he know? Vision, yes, because then Moses was a prophet. So it's very important to see these things, because the atheists or those who do not believe in the Bible would say, ah, the Bible is just created by man, or it's just written by no. They would criticize the Bible, right? But if you read the Bible, this contains the guidelines on how we have to live our life. We are in the world, but not of the world, and we should not act like the world and copy the customs and traditions of the world. That's one thing that I was thanking God for. These little things that, you know, popped up in your mind, I know that it's the Holy Spirit that make you realize that God is real. God is real, and just look at yourself in the mirror. Who created you? Single-celled molecule from the ocean? Big Bang Theory? No. You're not created by a chance or by a blowing of a volcano or from monkey. Oh, no way. I can't accept that. No? Can you? No. No way. No. Because if evolution is true, then what's next to monkey? Monkeys are still monkeys today. How many years? How many thousands of years now that monkey came to existence? And they're still monkeys today. Did your monkey... we don't have a monkey. Our neighbor, yeah, we had a neighbor before. He had a monkey. He would catch the kudus here in the head. And the monkey died a long time ago, but he did not turn into a person and act like a human being. No, it's not true. Look at yourself in the mirror. You are an evidence that God is real. Yeah, there's a lot of evidence. Yeah, the holes in your nose. Why is it there? Or this in the ears. Right, it's true. There are things that, what is that? Say that again. Yeah. Right. The mammal family, they classify that mammals. Some takes 9 months to before childbirth, and some 3 months, 2 months. You know, those are the God's, what is that? His wonderful works in many things. Yeah, his moving, his power. So God is real. There is no question about that. Just the examples, look at yourself in the mirror. The verses, just 9 verses, I would just read this. Praise ye the Lord. This is found in Psalms 149. Praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise in the congregation of saints. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises unto him with a timbrel and harp. Let me pause for a moment. This let them praise his name in the dance. This is not the worldly dance. The lewd gestures and movements and their nakedness. They hardly wear anything. You know, just cover the blah blah parts and the rest is nakedness. That's not the dance that David is talking about. And we don't do that. We dance for him for joy. We jump, you know, we're very happy, but not in the form of worldly dance. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. He will beautify the meek with salvation. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds. So even if we are in our bed, have you experienced that? You sing in your beds? I think you should start doing that. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand. What is the two-edged sword again? Sharper than a two-edged sword, the Bible, the Word of God, to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishments upon the people, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute upon them the judgment written. This honor have all his saints. Praise ye the Lord. So that's a very nice chapter. And my praises, I will continue my praises, of course, for the good health, for, and I would not forget, it's the trials. Are you thanking God for the trials? Life is not an easy walk. If you follow the Bible, you will encounter many trials. The people in the world, nah, it's okay. Do this, do that. Enjoy life, right? No restrictions, no limitations, no boundaries. Just do whatever you want. But if we want to be rewarded with the salvation of the Lord, we need to use the Bible as the rule in our life. And of course, because we are not sinless, we fail many times. We make mistakes, we make failures, but his promise is if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive. But that's not a license to willfully, no, you could care less, you will just do it no matter what. And for the food in the table, do you have food in your table? Did you have breakfast today? Was there a meal that there was no food in your table? No, look around you, there's lots of food, and we thank God for that. And of course, for the healing and for the people who are blessed by our videos. I'm about to end so that others could speak. As you know, we've been working with so we've been working with exposing false preachers. We're so fired up, right? We're always exposing false preachers to warn other people. And then this one person just sent an email. He's from Kansas, Missouri. Let's read what he said. I've been watching the YouTube videos. I think I was almost deceived by SDR and the Vern Bates thing. They do claiming to have Ellen G. White writings. I saw your YouTube channel, and then it hit me that I could not trust no one. Now I'm reading the Bible. Are you still active? So it's things like this that give us, like it's a hug from heaven. Your labors are not in vain. In those other people who have not the chance to write. So whatever we do to warn others, to tell others of the truth, you just don't know who they are, and they're blessed by it. And some, you don't see the results. So leave the results to God. Let us continue to do the work, unite in this, spreading the gospel of truth, especially this Bible, because this is the most important book you could ever have in your life. This is going to answer your questions, why you're depressed, why you're sad, why you're frustrated, why you're anything in this world. You open this book because this is the only book that will bring us into salvation. It could solve our problems. It will lead us into the path of righteousness to hopefully receive eternal life. And this is my prayer. Amen.
So happy Sabbath and good morning, everyone. For my thanksgiving and praise, I thank the Lord that I am doing well in school. Doing well for me means that I am not procrastinating in my tasks because God gives me the motivation to do them, such as being able to lead in our group activities and get good learnings out of it. Despite of our busy schedules, my friends in school and I still get to continue to do Bible study as we also encourage others to join. I also thank God for helping me get approval to have a special exam schedule since our exam schedule falls on a Saturday. Like today, it's my exam day and I get to take it on Monday instead. Lastly, I also thank the Lord for always giving me the courage to stand up for His truth and be different from the rest. My classmates and teachers already understand that I don't celebrate man-made traditions such as birthdays, family days, and Christmas parties that I get exempted from participating. I'd like to end my thanksgiving with a verse found in Romans 1:16 because this reminds us that wherever God puts us, we are to serve Him through our dealings with others and to share His gospel of truth. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. And that is all. Thank you and happy Sabbath.
Okay, so good morning once again, everyone, and happy Sabbath. Let me begin with a verse found in Psalms 140 verse 13. Surely the righteous shall give thanks unto thy name, and the upright shall dwell in thy presence. So this verse reminds me to always be grateful from all his providence, whether it be small or big. And for the month of November, I am thankful that he's keeping us, my family, safe and provided from all our needs, and also for the strength and courage to withstand every storm come in our life. And remember that a righteous man shall remember the Lord's goodness even persecuted, and a righteous man shall give glory into his name forever and ever. Amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to all. I would like to start with a verse found in Isaiah 42 verse 5. It says here, "Thus saith God the Lord, He hath created the heavens and stretched them out, he that spread forth the earth and that which cometh out of it, he that giveth breath unto the people upon it and spirit to them that walk therein." So imagine that, how long would you hold your breath? So you cannot hold your breath within a hour or how many seconds only that you can hold your breath. So imagine that God has given us the breath. He gave it as breath in order us to live. So as long as you live, you still have a chance to repent and to praise God. So when you fall, don't stop standing and strive the good fight of faith again, because as long as you live, you have a chance every day, daily or hourly. No, never.
The next verse.
So never stop repenting and go to God, cling to Him. And the second verse will be found in 1 Chronicles 19 verse 13. It says here, "Be of good courage and let us behave ourselves valiantly for our people." So what did this verse means, that let us behave ourselves valiantly for the people? So in this verse, this means that we should be alive, alert, and be enthusiastic. No? So last Sabbath, now we have a general meeting about how we could dwell here. So it is good that we have to dwell here in this church to be alert and be alive. And sometimes I feel sometimes what do you call that? Ang makuan po ba? Maduka, no? Pero usahay makakalit lang kag kuan, ano? Kuan na day. But sometimes lang la, no? Dili po permanente, no? And for the cities of our God. So what is the cities of our God? The cities of our God is the Jerusalem. But sadly to say that Jerusalem rejected the Christ, the Messiah. So that's why we are to be kaning puli or the unsa na? Yeah, we are the spiritual cities of our God as a replacement of the literal city Jerusalem or Israel. And let the Lord do that which is good in His sight. So this Sabbath, I would like to praise God for all the blessings He had given to me, for the strength and for the life that I breathe. And as long as we breathe, we have a chance to live and to strive to fight our battles every day. Our battles wouldn't end as long as we breathe. Our battles will end when we die. But when we die, we should secure that we live and we die in the Lord. And that's all. God bless.
Hello. And it's nice to be here again. Okay, every Sabbath day is a blessing, no? To all the people who love the Lord. My testimony and praises for this day can be found. I have a verse here. Can be found in Exodus 14, 1 Peter 5:8. Pakyaw na ni. Psalms 28:7. I'll just read. The Lord shall fight for you, and He shall hold your peace. And in Bisaya, si Jehovah makig-away alang kaninyo ug maghilom kamo. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. In Bisaya, magmalinaon kamo sa unahuna, managtukaw kamo, ang inyong kaaway, nga mao ang yawa, nga nagalibot-libot sama sa leon, nga nagangulob, nga nangitag iyang matukob. Life is full of confusion, right? And deceitfulness. We don't know anymore what to do. Some of us don't know anymore how to identify what is right and wrong because we are exposed to the www. And you know what is that? Yeah, it is the World Wide Web. All coming there with so many stuffs. The true and false, right? What I am thankful to God is that because He taught me the truth. This kind of life we are living is very tough. Many things are happening as if it's an ordinary lang. Seeing it thoroughly, we can conclude that it's no longer the normal way. People are happy seeing the opposite of what was God is trying to teach us, the right way. Since Satan is living with us, troubles are everywhere, doubled, because this is the last chance of Satan. Every second, when you are in the truth, you can identify his works. Satan is already here with us, but still the world cannot identify. Instead, they dance with his deceivable works. He is trying to destroy God's creations, works, and plans. He is happy seeing what's happening today. And we are his targets, the children of God, the people who love to work for the Lord. And he is trying to stop our works. Nay COVID and etc. Just like me, in my workplace, he is trying to stop me. So, what I am doing right now is I am silently praying and talking to God every now and then, since He is our only Savior in this troubled and convulsing world. Nag-convulsion na ang kalibutan. So, I will give you this last verse in that can be found in Psalms 28:7. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusteth in Him. And I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoiceth. And with my song will I praise Him. In Bisaya, si Jehovah maong akong kusog o ang akong taming. Ang akong kasing-kasing kaniya misalig. O gitabangan ako. Busa, nalipay og dako ang akong kasing-kasing. O sa akong awit pagadaigon ko siya. Good morning again. Happy Sabbath. And God bless us all.
Happy Sabbath once again, brother and sister. Today I'm late because I'm secure first my beloved my wife that she's okay because she's having now a fever. So I make sure that she's okay and I'm here now to share my testimonies. Brothers and sisters, if you have trials and temptation, what will you do? Do you will act like this if the trials and temptation will come to you? You will say like this? No. You will think that the trials and temptation is bothering you or is going you as struggling your life or making you burdens or you're murmuring that. Have you experienced this, brother and sister? So when the trials and temptation, when I experience this, I'm asking of myself, why I'm murmuring this? Why I'm complaining to the Lord and why I'm condemning and blaming others? Why instead I'm blaming of myself that I cannot deny myself? When I'm searching myself, brothers and sisters, I found out that I'm lacking something, that I need to be purify myself. I need to change my life the way I am. So it rebukes me, and I will not afraid now of the trial temptation. And I will pray to the Lord, there's more temptation and trials, Lord, that will come to me because I want to change my life. I want to know what I'm lacking to you. That's why I'm sometimes alone in my garden. I'm thinking that the temptation is always, when it's that day come temptation and trials, I'm arguing it, I'm murmuring it, but I'm said to myself, no, you must face the trials and you must deny yourselves and think something that God wants you to change. And I found out, brother and sister, that one thing that you have at facing a trials and temptations, you need to be fasting and praying. That will help us that we are lacking something to our God. He wants us to be purified because this we're facing an investigative judgment that we're facing about the second coming of our Christ. Brother and sister, what if when probation comes, close of probation comes, are you ready or are you thinking of yourself that you can have another chance, but probation is closing now? So, brothers and sisters, let us repent of all what we have without sin. Let us focus on God, not on earthly things, not on Facebook, TikTok, etc. Focus in God. Read the Bible. So my verse is, this is very special to me because when I receive the light, no, when I am a born again Christians, I came back, I'm through the Jehovah Witnesses and different denominations I came, but when I received the light, that brother of sister Missile, brother Clint, he shared to me what is the God's light, and I received it. And when I'm studying the Word of God, the Bible study guide that we are preaching it, and I study about the seven plagues, seven trumpets, mark of the beast, I study that very carefully. And I found this verse in Revelation 24. This is very special to me because this verse is posed to our former many, many years ordained. So, the Revelation 24, and I saw thrones, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them, and I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus, and for the word of God, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, there that had received this mark upon their foreheads, on their hands and they live and reign with Christ 1,000 years. So this verse, brother and sister, this is not happen on the sixth plague. This is happen on before provision closes. So remember the cards that we are giving to people to warn them about the coming universal Sunday law. This is what you given us, many ordained pastor. You're not really ordained pastor. So these cards that will expose you, and you will say this on your cards that in Revelation 24, this is card that expose you and your lies. When I read your study, your seven trumpets, that's not a seven trumpets, that is seven lies. It's all historic events, and it's lie. And that's all. Happy Sabbath to you, brother and sister.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to everyone. I want to read Psalms 107, 21 to 22. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, and let them sacrifice the sacrifices of thanksgiving and declare his works with rejoicing. The Bible says that giving thanks through pain is a sacrifice, and when we sacrifice to the Lord and offer him thanksgiving, even through difficult situation, our God is praised. When we heartily shift our focus from our pain and suffering to how God is working in us and through us, then he reveals his strength in our weaknesses. We have so much to be thankful for in every circumstances. So if you go through trials, remember that scriptures is perfectly divine. In there, God speaks and says in Jeremiah 31:25, "For I have satiated the weary soul, and I have replenished every sorrowful soul." There are times when we are weary, and there are times when we are weak. In those times, we need to listen to what God's word is telling us, not what our circumstances are saying. So despite the circumstances we are facing now, all praise and thanksgiving to God for being always with me and my family, for the protection, love, blessings, and all the answered prayers that he grant us. And that's all.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. It was not on my plan to come here, no, because last night my daughter got a little bit fever, but now she's fine, and I just know that the fever is just around the corner, guys. Sister Mawi got fever, Timisil, no. So I praise God, no. I feel forfeited and guilty if I will not come here, because in karon nga buntag, she's doing fine now, no. She's okay, but her face is just so pale. No? So in Psalms 139:17-18. How precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I should count them, they are more in number than the sand. And I awake, I am still with thee. So if I were to count all the exhaustion in my heart, it couldn't be counted just by hand. Yet, there is more and more reason to be thankful for more than that. Now first, I praise God for all he has given to my family, included the things that I don't see at first as a blessing, but it is. For blessing me a partner, shout out na sa that, understands and support me. For working hard every day to meet our daily needs. For the love and sacrifices he made, no? Everything is appreciated. And baguhay lang, no, one time at this guy saw us clinging each other. And hagwa-hagwa God, and she told us, Mo na'y husband og wife, maglablab, dili magfight. No? And that moved me. No, there I realized that a neglected relationship between husband and wife causes so much tension and stress in the family that everyone suffers and stress so much suffers, especially the kids, no? But when the marriage is healthy, those who benefits more is the children. So when the parents are expressive and loving toward each other, the kids feel more secure, and we parents able to let them see God's goodness, and it gives them a glimpse of Jesus' love for all of us. And they also have a positive model to follow for their future marriages. But we know, akong napay time, no? But we know there are no perfect relationships. But let us try our best to show that love should exceed more than the arguments, the pride, and the anger. In 1 Peter 4:8, and above all things, have fervent charity among yourselves, for charity shall cover the multitudes of sins. And I also praise God for all the provisions, for the healing, protection, guidance, and all the realizations that wake me up. In Psalm 68:19, blessed be the Lord who daily loadeth us with benefits, even the God of our salvation, Selah. That's all.
Hello, everyone. Happy Sabbath. No, especially those who are watching in live, happy Sabbath to all. No, first of all, I would like to thank our Lord Jesus for the healing. No, last night I have a toothache, but now it's gone. No, I'm very thankful for that, and also for the protection in all my ways. No, yesterday when I driving the scooter, no, going to the now, no, very loaded and very hard to maneuver. No, I'm very thankful for guiding me and keeping me safe. And pasalamat po kun Junbi kay Junbi push the bike going up there, it's very muddy. No, guwas Junbi ato maglisod jug saka ato. No, salamat kay Brad. Thank you. No, I'm very thankful for the good health. No, condition ng lawas. Good running condition. And for the kining food, abundance of food. Now, I will share to you my verse. No, ginahan kay ko ning a verse, no? No, kaning kanunay ning maga kwans ko abitaw. Now in Proverbs 12:25, anxiety in a man's heart weighs him down, but a good word makes him glad. Nandindot kaysa, no? No, sa Bisaya, ang kaguol nga anaa sa kasing-kasing sa usa ka tawo maoy makapatiko kaniya. Apan ang usa ka maayong pulong makapahimo nini nga malipayon. No, pinaagi sa pulong, no? No, mahimong malipayon ang tawo, no? Depende sa pulong. No, kaya naman po yung pulong makapasakit. No, nindot ko na siya nga verse, no? No, Solomon points out in this verse that worry is not a small burden. The cares of this world can weigh heavily on the heart and cause a person to despair or feel depressed or anxiety. However, a kind word, a word of encouragement can lift his drooping spirit and cheer him up. No, this echoes the sentiment of Proverbs 12:18. No, Proverbs 12:18. There is that speaketh like the piercings of a sword, but the tongue of a wise is health. No, in Bisaya, adunay magapamulong sa hinanali sama sa mga paglagbas sa usa ka espada. Hinanali. Apan ang dila sa manggialamon makaayo. No, which spoke about the healing or hurting power of words. No, other proverbs also note the importance of carefully choosing and applying our words. No, in Proverbs 10:31 to 32, Proverbs 11:12 and Proverbs 15:1. No, Proverbs 10:31 and 32. The mouth of the just bringeth forth wisdom, but the froward tongue shall be cut out. The lips of the righteous knows what is acceptable, but the mouth of the wicked speaketh frowardness. In Bisaya, ang ba-ba sa matarong magabunga o kaalam, apan ang dila nga masukihon pagaputlon. 32. Ang mga ngabil sa matarong mahibalo sa angay nga pagadawaton, apan ang ba-ba sa daotan nagapamulong sa pagkamasukihon. No, Proverbs 11:12. He that is void of wisdom despiseth his neighbor, but a man of understanding holdeth his peace. Ang Bisaya, kadtong nagatamay sa iyang isig katawo walay kaalam, apan ang tao nga may salabutan nagahilom. No, my last verse in Proverbs 15:1. A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. No, ang usak 15 unday ni. Ang tubag nga malumo makapahumpay sa kapungot, apan ang pulo nga mahait makapapukaw sa kasuko. No, mo ni no ang ato ang mga words, no, ato juning matngunan, no, sa paggamit, no, og nakapasakit ba ta or kahimutan ba ni atubangan sa Ginoo? O ngara to, happy Sabbath once again.
So good morning and happy Sabbath everyone. So today I'm gonna share what I have learned from the First Kings, the book of First Kings. So the past last month, November, we've been reading that book every morning and evening, and it you can learn from it that God punishes those who are serving other gods. Like during King David's reign on Israel, over Israel, he, of course, he sins, he committed adultery, but God never left him because he never served other gods. He only stick to one God despite of being sinful. But after King David, there's Solomon. He asked for wisdom. He was given all the riches and all the knowledge and wisdom from the Lord. But despite being provided all that, he served other gods, the gods and the goddesses of her of his wives, Chemosh, there's Baal and other gods. So God told Solomon that because you serve other gods, he rebuked Solomon, but then he did not listen right away. So God told Solomon that because David is your father, I will not let bad things happen on your time, but on your son's reign. So evil came on his son's reign. The kingdom was divided, then he was taken over by other, by the captains, by other kings, other nations, and so on. And other, like, new kings of Israel and Judah, they are fighting over the land, and they were fighting over the throne. And it was terrible just for serving, so other kings, new kings come, like, at first they serve God, then later on they sin and then serve other gods again. So it's like a routine, a very bad routine. They serve and they disobey God. So the throne gets removed. So what I learned from it is when you serve other gods, it will disappoint God and it will make him feel sad. And of course, your blessing will be removed from you. So that's the lesson that I learned from our reading, from our daily readings. And for Thanksgiving, I thank God for the protection for the whole month of November. His protection over my family, our brethren, and also for our animals and our properties. Knowing November, it was very rainy, there's typhoons and landslides all over the country, and also to our brethren in other countries. But still, God protected us and our properties. He did not let bad things happen to it. And also for the blessings, the daily providence, the good health, also especially at the shop, for my husband's protection, and also with Brother Ronel for keeping them safe always. When using the tools and the grinders, it scares me a lot, because a lot of accidents happens when you use the grinders. And also I thank the Lord especially for keeping the baby healthy for more than 6 months now. And that's all. Thank you and happy Sabbath, everyone.
And good morning. And happy Sabbath once again. And I would like to start with this verse found in Hebrews 12, verse 1. Wherefore, seeing we are also compassed about with so great a cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. So, run with patience. So, muna siya. Kinala na dyan tayo.
Pailub.
On my thanksgiving, I would like to thank God for keeping us safe and for providing our needs. You know, most of us here are self-employed. But still, we're able to survive because God give us our needs, especially food and shelter. And one thing also, I'm so thankful that God bless us love. Love from God, from our wife, from our husband, love from our neighbor, from friends. Kaning genuine nga love. Kabaw yung sa isip, sa salita, at sa gawa. Kay lisod kayo. Kay kung wala na gayang gugma sa panimalay, ang resulta unsa man? Gubot jud. But God, gi-bless ta niya with so much love. Katuwa po na siyang ma-feel. Dirin ko taman, happy Sabbath.
So good morning and happy Sabbath everyone. Okay ra, happy ratanan. And happy Sabbath also to our new visitor. And first, I would like to thank God for this another Sabbath again. And I'm thankful for all the blessings that I receive all throughout the month. And for the safety and protection from all the travels. And especially to my family and to all the brethren that is traveling. For providing our daily needs, both spiritual and physical food. For the Holy Spirit that has been my comforter and my guide, my decision in life, and certainly how I handle and react to some things. And I'm thankful for the Bible, for who have taught me a lot of knowledge, wisdom and understanding. You know, it's indeed, you know, our guide as we get through in this life. And for renewing my strength in times when I feel weak. But, you know, here we are praising God and give to His glory. And we keep fighting to and striving to be better each and every day. You know, life is full of challenges. And I'm just thankful that every day God gives me power to withstand the daily challenges in life. Like each morning, I'm just thankful that I have another gift of life. And like every day, I talk to myself and I talk to God and says, like, okay, this is just another morning and I'm happy, another challenges, but I trust in you, Lord, that we'll get through this. And these past weeks have been so busy, or let's say maybe a month. You know, it's been so busy for me, relocating, traveling here and there, and doing this, doing all this stuff. You know, it feels so exhausting and really tired. Not just physically tired, but also like it affects you mentally and emotionally. And there were times like this past week, I have been feeling so exhausted. Like, it's not just like kaning simple rang of being exhausted like from all the work. It's like I cannot say taw gani, di na ko ma-distinguish kung unsa siya bitaw. So I was like, unsa man koy kanang lahi magyud. I feel so uninspired. I think that's the word, uninspired. Like, yes. I was like, unsa man ni uninspired. So I was like asking to God, like, Lord, what's happening? It's like I'm tired, but I cannot say it's physically tired. It's something deeper than that. So I question myself, like, unsa man, what should I do? So what I did, I went to the gym. I went to the gym because maybe I need to let out my stress. Because before I used to do that, like go to the gym and kanang sweat out to give off the stress. No, so I signed up for 2 months. So 3 months going on and off to the gym, bitaw. And I was just like going and off, coming in here. But kani bitaw walay na hitabo, nothing changed. I was like, wa mangi na kaning sa banisyo ay kaning I don't see changes. I don't feel nga kanang inspired. I don't feel nga murag luya ya po nga what jo kasab sa mning luya ha nga wa man jud ko kasabot ning luya ha. So again, now I ask the Lord again, bitaw. I ask the Lord, like, Lord, please help me. You know, I don't understand this. I don't know what's going in my mind, mentally, physically, emotionally. Like, please guide me and enlighten me. So it's something that I cannot figure it out myself. So again, life continue, no, as it is. And one night I was here and I was reading my Bible that time. So suddenly, I mean, I have na ako kaning chapter bitaw nga ako jung gisunod. Like, I have a chapter that I used to read. And then suddenly it came up on my mind, like, I still want to read more. So I was like making a kanang random bitaw lang a pick of verses. Like, I was just like picking on my Bible. It's like, okay, I will just pick a random verse. So I was going on the book of poetry, like, because I need an advice on what's going on. So I went to the chapter of Ecclesiastes. So there was a verse that really hits me hard, like so hard. So I will read it in Ecclesiastes 4 verse 6. Better is a handful with quietness than both the hands full with travail and vexation of the spirit. And this really hit me so hard lagi. Like, okay, I was like, okay, maybe this is a sign, no? Like, I told my mom, like, look, I want to stop this. I want to stop, keep coming back here in the city. I want to spend more time in the countryside. And I just want to, like, relax bitaw. So what I did is, like, I decide myself, like, maybe kanang, how I say this one, I just want to stop, keep coming back in the city. Like, kaning gusto lang sa ko mo spend more time in the countryside to evaluate myself. So that's what I did. I came up here and I stayed longer than I used to do, no? So I garden, I work around my house. Like, unsa na lang ako gipambuhat nga what I need to do. So, it's been like not even a week. It's just like few days, and I feel a sign of relief. Like, honestly, like, I feel like every time I wake up in the morning, like, I feel kanang peace of mind. I feel like I'm in touch with God, I'm in touch with nature, with Tao. And it's like doing the things I need to do here in the countryside. Like, I feel kanang nag-gain bitaw kag strength. Like, little by little, nakayong ko nga, murag, I think this is what the Lord teaches me. Yes. I was like, Lord, indeed, your ways is not my ways. Like, my ways are like going to the gym. Maybe I just need to sweat out. But I think what I need is just like, because I know for myself, I need a quiet place where I can relax, where I can recharge, where I can evaluate what's going on myself. I've been asking myself, you know, how's your faith? You know, you have to also ask yourself, how is your faith? How is your relationship to God? How do you communicate to God? How to communicate yourself with the brethren, you know, and everyone else? So that's how I did. Because if you keep on doing things, and it's still no changes, then maybe you have to change something, right? Sani ka na bitaw, masigil lang tagbalik-balik, kabaw gay tang away na hitabo, pero we're still, you know, keep going on. And I thought to myself, like, maybe it's way sad nga, God telling me nga, you have to stay out more in the city, because in the city there's too much distraction. No, daghan kay distraction sa city. You cannot talk to God too much. Like, daghag trabaho, saba pa jud kaayo, there's too much noise, and it's like people are bothering you in there. So, and though I'm not saying no nga kaning, how I say this one, to, like, let's say natay mga work sa city, or like we have school and maybe something to do in the city, I don't mean that you have to give up that, you know, what you kind of work hard for. But what I'm trying to point about my verse is that sometimes, no, you really need to pause, to stop, to relax, recharge, and then evaluate yourself. And I think also this verse reminds us, as what King Solomon says, no nga, happiness and contentment lies on having less. But with a good conscience, with tranquility, with love and fear to God, and peace of mind and heart, than searching and working to have an abundant life, but taking away your peace of mind, more worries and stress. Because these are all vanity and vexation of the spirit, as King Solomon says. So I'll end my verse in Psalms 29:11. The Lord will give strength unto his people, and the Lord will bless his people with peace. Amen.
Happy Sabbath sa tanan, or Happy Sabbath everyone. English na to gamay. No, ako ah, no, inspired po, I was being inspired for the song, no, entitled sa to, When I Cry, You Cry, no. In the first stanza, no, murag nindot siya tinana ang pamalandungon nga, making a list of all of good things you've done. No, murag, yeah, kung imong hunaon-naon, kung palistahon ka sa Ginoo, ah, sa iyang mga maayong nabuhat sa imong kinabuhi from gikan sa imong from your first kananaang birth, no, kanang pag-anak gyud nimo, then padung sa atong kinabuhi karon, murag, no, kananang, yeah, kananang kulang gyud ang usa ka notebookan, or kananang it's not enough nga kananang mo kwantag isa ka librohan, no, gikan sa tanan yung mga kaayong nga gibuhat sa atong kinabuhi. And then I would like to give thanks to God for giving us strength, no, daily, no, that I can able to kneel down paghihapon, makaluhod paghihapon, murag din dapat din nato nang apasalamatan nga makaluhod pa ta,
despite or amidst of the all temptations, for the trials, no, for the pain we've been experienced, kahimo gihapon ta to kneel down, no, makahimo gihapon ta sa pagtawag. Then kana na ang physical strength nga gihatag nga God gives to us, no, especially sa trabaho gid sa garden. Kami ang tatay diha sa garden, murag pareha namong we're doing a plot, no, from our garden, murag unyag tuyhod, ah, back pain, Allah. Murag unyag unyag kadugayang binug kaneng binugwal sa yuta ba, murag unyag bangon ana-ana na kayo, no, kana, but we're so thankful to God na He gives us strength nga kana mabuhat na wala kay. Then pagkahuman, we're almost done. Now I look to our plot nga pagana la kita nagbuhat ani. Wala kinang dili katuhuan nga kita ra gimano-mano ra ba buhimo sa plot. And then now I'm giving also thanks for God for kana na ang giving me, put me in some uncomfortable situations in life. No, I'm so thankful for it kay pareha sa task ba nga din eh to maintain the church clean morag sa kada Friday nga mo hinlo-hinlo pagabot magkuhan pero wala kaneng kinahanglan mo itong kaya ni kwedeng doon kanina nga kinahanglan na agad tayo pailob morag kaninga I'm asking for kana na ang more patience in life ba niya gitubag sa Ginoo not in an easy way morag God answers your prayer for asking patience in life. Pero sa lahi nga paagi nga, uy, gusto dai kag pailob o sige. Sige, ay. Yo, kita ay kanay pag anak do. Ay kinsa mi laing mo kuan ani? Unang ang Israel ra ba, another reason nga why Israel nga kanan ang wala kasulod sa promised land kay tungod sa ilang pagkabugot-butan. So, purification dai mong gusto sige. Murag muna nga butangan angay na to nga pasalamatan, no, pero sometimes no because of the uncomfortable situations nga nidangat sa tong kinabuhi murag makaingam sa kakapuya eh, kinang sahay murag nindot ipahuway, no, sa una mga instances mo sa moabot sa muna una, pero when you're thinking on how far you go through, no, kanang murag ah giyaga-yagaan na gaita we've been kinanaang git ha say tawag na ridiculed sa mga ubang mga tao, daghan na kay tagpag-antos nga giagian sa kinabuhi, too much pain, no, this mga kanang stress kinabuhi, daghan we've kining let go anything na everything kinanaang nga makababag nya pag-abot day din sa punto sa imong kinabuhi is muundang raday ka. Number two, nakaanak ko kadugayan kining gardening helps me a lot good kinanaang to evaluate myself more na sa garden kay ukapoy para same thing sa garden. If you kinanaang tired doing something in the garden, just kinanaang take a kinanaang rest, no, never stop but take a rest, then when you gain another strength nasad to continue your journey, then padayo nasad murag inana ba kung kapuyon ka ayag kuan kinanaang ay surrender kinanaang have a break, yeah. Have a break lang then pag nanakay murag okay na mo padayo, no, sige continue nasad inana kay our life no murag it's not an easy way good mo ginatong ang ikana nang encourage matag usa nga di gid lalim atong dalan nga gilakwan kay gusto tao kay gusto ang Dios, no, kana na ang sa langit dili sayon atong sa langit is kana na ang puro putli ba mat kana na ang maayo ang makasulod dito, so we need nga kita kabalota nga we're lacking of something, we're so sinful, so we need to kana na ang evaluate dahil kana nang purify sa atong kinabuhi nga kung sasalaan ba para sa ayagan sa balas nga katong mapino kayo mo remang lusot basin ba yog dako na kayatong kananaang watay pagsusi dako na kayatong sala nya nahuot na dili ta kalusot dito sa ayag para nang ayagan sa balas di ta muungot dito sa ayagan nya sa laba kining ilahi na sad no inana sa atong pagkinabuhi no kinahanglan evaluate meditate gyud sa kanunay dayon pasalamat no para sa gingon mo na ade nga we must be thankful for the trials, for the pains, for the aches nga na naabot sa to ang kinabuhi kay kana ang pinaagi ni kaning pinaagi na mga butanga is nakahimo ta nga kung we overcome those pains, no, for those trials in life we will kana ang increase gud ba ang mahitabo sa imong kinabuhi nga mas magkalig-on ka sa imong pagpangalagad, no, kay kung madaog na nimo nga trials nga kana naan sa imong kinabuhi sa sunod ana, no, hantod nga sa ginagmay little by little nga mga pagsulay
magkadagko, magkakusgan sad ka, no mo na ang kanan importante nga kinahanglan, dili ta magtalaw. Then I would like to read this verse sa Marcos 10:27. No? Marcos 10, ah, naman is Marcos. Nasa English ang giingon din eh. And Jesus, looking upon them, saith with men, it is impossible, but not with God. For with God, all things are possible. No, we must, kanan, ang mogi na tong, ang ngayong huna-hunaon sa kanunay nga, lisod na atong dalan nga gilakwan din sa kalibutan, pero makaingon ta nga, imposibleng nato nga madaog, pero sa tubangan sa Ginoo, no nga source sa tanang kusog, source sa tanang kagahom, makahimo ta sa pagdaog anak nga mga pagsulay. Then sa, kanan na ang, name ay kaning kanang sana maghisgot sa paghisgot sa mga kanang cares about this life. Now I would like to read also verse found in Rome, First Peter 5:7. Ano man eh, tara. Casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. Sa Cebuano, nindot ko siya basahon, no? Itugyan ngadto kaniya ang inyong tanang kabalaka kaysa may kahangawa man alang kaninyo. Mo na kanindot murag wala, though we didn't have treasures in this life, no, wala tayong mga bahandi, wala tayo, we don't have para nabo, wala may, we have no cars, we have no kanana ang mansions kanang mga inana ba mga staff sa kinabuhi, pero we must be thankful because we're too lucky enough to have God who gives us we're too blessed, no nga, we're too blessed enough, no, we have God that gives us hope, although we don't have any kananaang treasures in this life, but He gives us all hope. No, imagine people around this world, no, who commit suicide because they cannot bear the depressions in life, no, mga trials, problems, mga kasakit sa kinabuhi. Pero atong pasalamatan nga ang Ginoo, tungod kay naatay Ginoo, is natay dako kayos nga tanan nga paglaom, no nga wala ta naghikog, wala naabot sa tungod na una nga maghikog, kay because natay koan Ginoo nga naghatag nato og paglaom sa tong kinabuhi nga duo lang nako isugid imong mga problema, then tagaan ti kag kasulbaran nga ikaw mismo sa imong kaugalingon sad ang mabuhat, no, kay bisan pag unsa ka kining unsa ka daghan sa pagkananaang pamaagi nya kita gyud ang dili imong himo, so wala lang gihapon dayon. Kining sa Mateo 11:28. Nanindot sa niyo sa Mateo 11:28. Mateo 11:28. Come unto me, and ye that labors and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Nanindot kayo mo na saad sa Ginoo. Na not only for kanang physical rest, no, pero sa tanan nato nga mga kabalaka, tagaantan niya og kahumpayan sa atong mga kasakit, no, for giving us kinang hope sa kinabuhi nga ang tanang pagsulay, ang tanang pagantos sa atong kinabuhi is naagyoy kahumanan, no, kung makaangkon ta sa kaluwasan nga gihatag, no, kung atong paningkamutan to work to our salvation's good sa kanunay, no, mo natong dapat focus sa atong kinabuhi, salvation, how's my faith, nga para makuha ang salvation mo gyud na dapat ato ipaka nang lansang sa tungod una. Na then kinisang katiloy nagsensit tiloy was sending me his testimony niya, basa-basa sad ko, then ganahan sad ko sa verse, no, kumurag this is kin common sad murag madungog nato, pero mapasalamaton kay ko, I'm so thankful to God that he gave this promise sa Isaiah 1:18. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sin is be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. No, murag kung kita sa tong kaugalingon, there's someone go against us. No, kana na murag nakapasakit sa tong kinabuhi. Makahimo ka ta ni nga kaan pasensya sa Ginoo, makakabot ka ta sa pailob. No, nga sama patience nga gihatag sa Ginoo nga. Let us reason together. Giagda pagyud sa Ginoo nga ngano na inani man eh, ngano na why you do nga nahimo nimo ni, why you commit this sin. No, God gives us kana ang chance to reason out ngano na inani, nganong nahimo nimo ni nga sala, nganong nakahimo, nganong imo ning nabuhat. No, kung kita sa tong kaugalingon na makasala din hinato, murag awa na basta sala gyud to nimo, suko gyud ko nimo. No, may nana ang batio nato, pero Pasalamat sa Ginoo nga naatay Dios nga naghigugma nato nga sa kanunay nagbuhat og mapailubon kaayos nga tanan sa walay pag-undang nung sa pagbubo sa iyang kaluoy sa matag usa nga bisan tuod klaro na gid kayo, it is so clearly that we've transgressed his law, no, naka we go kining sin against him, pero still he's asking nga come now nya kana na ang let us reason together lang gihapon, no. Kinim grabe kay ang pasensya sa Ginoo ba, nana sab nga kinahanglan we must possess the same character as kana na ang pareha sa Ginoo nga mapailubon, kana na ang kinahanglan mo meditate gud sa kanunay nga kun unsa ang pinakamaayo nga buhaton, no, ako na may mga kapakyasan nga mahitabo mabuhat sa atong isig katawo or bisan asa, kana na ang ato pong tagaan pareha sa Ginoo ba nga ngano na inani man ni Brad, ngano na inani sus dili kay pagkasala plo patak-patak na dayon ko ano kinahanglan ang at kay ang giingon biya dito no nga kung mas kining kinahanglan nato para tong parabol ba nga gisalik kining gisalikway gipagawas gitambog sa gawas sa kumbira sa kanang ana kung girgi sa kasal kay nga naman dinapit kining although invited siya sa kasal pero wala man siya nagsuot sa bisti nga para sa kasal gipagawas na it's the same thing nga we are elected though we are elected nya we if we don't wear kanana ang ganan ang the character of Christ, no, there is a great possibilities nga mapalagpot gyud ta. No mo na kinahanglan, evaluate na ta tong kaugalingon every day in every seconds in our life nga kanana ang nagsul-o baka ka do I wear the character of Christ, no, sul-o baka nako ang kinaiya ni Kristo nga mao'y sumbanan para makasulod sa langit og tinhira ko taman and happy Sabbath and thank you once again. O then ako lang po ding lahusog ko an basa kang Atiloy. I would like to read that Sister Lois kinanaang testimony. The good morning and blessed Sabbath, brethren. I praise the Lord for His great love and mercy, forgiveness, forbearance, good health for the family, brethren, and He always provide our needs. And also God allowed me to experience trials and problems. This makes me realize that I have a God that will help me to go through it. Now as He promised in His word, Psalms 23 verse 5, Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. I'm so thankful to the Lord that the burden in taking care of our little one is not that heavy, and if there are some cares and problems, God always there providing help. Because being a mother is not always easy, but being here in the truth, it helps a lot to save all the unnecessary pains and troubles that are expected to happen. I'm thankful to the Lord also for our garden that is supplying more than our needs and for making it prosper because we ourselves cannot make a single fruit of it. God commands and it happens. And God allows, and God also blessed because He, a God in heaven who knows how to reward and to make happy of all laboring hand. Big praise again to our God who lives forever. And my testimony is about the mental battle. Now when fall short, I can hear something saying, oh, you're too sinful, you cannot make it. But I remember the word of God, the word of Lord, He will forgive His people if we acknowledge our sins, and He will abundantly pardon us. Now as Ms. Isaiah verse 1:18 said, come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord, though your sin be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. The story in Old Testament, how God is being merciful for His people. When Satan plays our minds, we should go and seek the word of God to remind us that all, that's all, brethren, and God bless us all. Let's kneel down for the prayer. So, Father in heaven, we thank you for this wonderful Sabbath that we've heard a lot of testimonies from coming from our brethren that inspires us to give us more hope to continue this battle of life, that we may, for the next chapter of our life, we may gain victory, you know, through your name, that we can makuha na mo ang kaluwasan ng among gipaningkamutan nga sa kanunay unta kami gain og patience in life no, to grow and prosper sa kanunay og pour us your Holy Spirit to guide us and remind us what the right thing to do. Kay wala may arang mahimo kung wala ikaw nga magagiya ka namo sa kanunay Amahan. Og sa mapangayoon, we're asking for the forgiveness of our all sins in thought, words, and deeds, and we're also asking for the protection nga magkabulag-bulagay may karon nga ikanto sa kanunay magatipig sa mong kinabuhi nga walay kakulian nga mudangat. O kini among gipayag itugyan sa gamhan ng ngalan sa ni Ginoong Hesus ug sa tabon sa Espiritu Santo. Amen.